Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and I didn't think I would do it, but yes indeed, I'm extending the Christmas 2010 holiday season. Why? Let me tell you why. I still have Christmas gifts to wrap, and here we are. The date is moving right along. Let's look at the pile.
It's not a very large pile. It's like a Gomer pile, and that's a crappy joke, but what did you expect? So let's just wrap this stuff. It really shouldn't take that long, and we'll just be done with it.
Little Drew's father, Todd, told me that his son is fairly artistic. Yeah, right. Everyone's kid is artistic. Everyone's a musician. Everyone's an athlete, whatever. Anyway, going on the theme of artistic, let me show you what I got him.
I got him the You Draw game tablet for the Nintendo Wii. So it's a drawing tablet, drawing surface for the Wii system, which I think is actually kind of cool. But you know what? With the whole thing with the Wii and the Wiimote,
let's just hope the little kid doesn't realize that he's not an artist, get pissed off, and throw the thing at the freaking LCD TV. So that would be funny. I don't know if it has like a strap for your wrist. Let's wrap it.
The box says, unleash your inner Picasso. Because if Picasso was inside you, you'd probably go, eh. And there's the final wrap to Drew from Uncle Al. Don't throw it at the TV wrap. Now, it actually came out kind of good. I mean, it looks good in the front, but if you flip it in the back, you can really see the crappy wrap job. I actually tried to seriously wrap this so it looked okay as the first one, but that's the best I could do. And you know, okay, so it looks like crap. It's late. And notice the technique, though, here, because it is going to be shipped. There's an extra piece of industrial packing tape over the bow, so the bow does indeed stay secure. But there it is, the first late wrapping, and now moving right along.
I'll tell you, I'd like to personally thank Justin Bieber. Why? I'll tell you why. Because Justin Bieber made it easy to select gifts for the teenage girls in the family. So what are we getting Drew's little 13-year-old sister, Alexandra? Let me show you.
We're getting her the 2011 Justin Bieber wall calendar, and at the rate that I'm wrapping these gifts, maybe I should just get her the 2012 calendar. And the 100% official Justin Bieber First Step 2 Forever My Story book. The Justin Bieber Our World book. The Get the Scoop book. The acoustic CD and Rolling Stone. He's on the front cover of the Rolling Stone.
It's all good. He's giving a positive message out there. He's cranking out some music. God bless Usher. Usher embraced him and kind of got him out there. The only problem I have with Justin Bieber as of right now is the fact that I bought this crap through Amazon. So every time I do my shoplifting on Amazon, he keeps on recommending other Justin Bieber crap. I say nay, nay. It was just a one-time purchase. Let's wrap this stuff.
Well, except for the calendar, I'm just going to shove this crap back in the Amazon box that it came in, really. But wait, there's a stocking stuffer. Let's also throw in the Grayson Chance CD. Now, he was embraced by Ellen DeGeneres, and he's the one that did that acoustic paparazzi. Let's do the official Alfred.tv rendition of that.
You need a bigger fan, your CPU is quite a hottie. Airflow is sloppy, your motherboard runs hot, just like your girlfriend's tightly coded bot. I said tightly coded bot. Hey, she was a software developer. Because I know people are going to ask, what are the chords? One of the chords is the very simple chords for that chorus in Paparazzi. We start out with an inverted C major chord to the G major chord, to A minor, then down to F major, and that's it. Which you can also use for the song Forever Young. I wanna be forever young. Or as the mighty, mighty Adam B would say, Loretta Young. I wanna be Loretta Young. Ooh, and the speaker just like blitzed, whatever. I always have a problem with her name. I'm not sure if it's Alexandra or Alexandria. Let me show you the workaround.
We just keep it nice and simple to Alex from Uncle Al, and it's a Chance Bieber, B-E-E-B-A-H, spelled phonetically the way I say it. It's the Chance Bieber box set. Nice Amazon wrap. Now I gotta deal with that freaking calendar. Look at this, I'm gonna get fancy. I'm gonna shake things up a bit. I'm gonna actually use different wrapping paper. A nice white, a nice white with the snowman on it. And why did the snowman drop his pants?
Because he heard the snowblower coming. Oh, old joke. Let's take a look at the backside of the calendar.
Calendar. Spelled phonetically the way I say it. C-A-L-E-N-D-A-H. Now, I noticed that this photo of Justin Bieber, I think they might be using this for an underarm commercial. And the voiceover would be, that's right, new right guard used by musicians everywhere. Whatever. Let's wrap this freaking thing. And here is the final wrap. Notice a little bit of overhang, but that never hurt anyone. And I wrote on the label, to Alexandra or Alexandria, pick one from Uncle Al. And since it's a calendar and it's very late, it says, I owe you 2 months on this one.
In the Rolling Stone article, Justin Bieber said how he admired Michael Jackson and liked Michael Jackson and all the good things he did. I'm sure Michael Jackson would unfreeze himself from his cryonic storage just to hang out with Justin Bieber for a day. Now, one thing that I thought was odd, though, Justin Bieber wears Band-Aids on his fingertips, at least it's referenced in the article. When they asked him why, he says, I don't know, I like Band-Aids. Michael Jackson wore Band-Aids on the tips of his finger. A friend that saw him down in Florida saw Michael Jackson without Band-Aids on his fingers. His fingernails are, like, really nasty and, like, effed up. I hope Justin Bieber has a good manicurist. Whatever. Oh, crap. I knew I should have checked all the inventory before I started all this rap. There's one more Justin Bieber piece for Alexandra or Alexandria. Pick one. Here we go.
It's the Justin Bieber Backstage Pass board game. But watch what we're going to do. Alfred.tv at its finest. We're going to do a little bit of an edit job. A little bit of a label. That's better. And the final wrap with some lovely Santa Claus paper. With, of course, extra industrial packing tape on the bow. To Alexandra or Alexandria. Pick one. I'm from Uncle Al. More Bieber. Let's take a look at the back of the package. Nate, is this... yeah, is this great? Listen, this wrapping technique is absolutely acceptable because of these movies. All the guys out there who can't rap for shit should thank me for making this comedic and acceptable. Because if you can rap good, if you can really rap good,
and you're a guy, there's something wrong with you. Really. And for my little cousin Troy, for his basement, where he does his video gaming sessions, when we play on Xbox Live and he kicks my butt, I had purchased for him a laser system from Spencer, S-P-E-N-C-A, Spencer's Gifts. And his little brother Drew tripped on the power pack and broke it. So basically this is a replacement laser. See, I really got Troy his gift already. I got him Halo Reach with the statue. You know, that Halo Reach package with a really nice statue that's already on the junk pile for like $60. Man, that thing was expensive. Anyway, let's take a look at this laser.
It's the Laser Theater, and it's guaranteed to give you chicks in your basement with their arms up. There you have it. And it does a variety of patterns. You have a couple of different lenses you can put on, and it's both a green and red laser. So let's cut to my ceiling in the living room because I bought one for myself. It's a nice product.
And here's a little bit of footage of this laser. There's several different lenses you can put on, so there's several different patterns. It's actually quite nice. I do recommend it. It's both red and green. Nice. Add in a blue laser and you can get like a projection TV on your ceiling. Whatever.
Final wrap job, just absolutely beautiful. To Troy from Uncle Al with the message, don't let Drew break this. But there's an ancillary message on the side. Look at how well this is wrapped. It looks like the Elephant Man's face. Don't ever snipe me in Halo or Call of Duty. I really hate getting sniped in those video games. It's coming out so lovely. I'm so proud.
Now, this is a traditional purchase from my friend David the Creative One. And this is the official shot glass from Halloween Horror Nights. But what makes this one special, this one is the 20th anniversary shot glass. Isn't this nice? So this is being sent up with the package I'm sending to his family. Quite lovely, blood red.
it's wrapped in tissue paper, and I have it then secondary wrapped in a Harry Potter, the Wizarding World of Harry Potter bag. Yeah, bag. And I tell you, the ride at this part of the park at Islands of Adventure, Universal Studios Islands of Adventure, the ride is really outrageous. So I'm going to wrap it in the bag, and then it's going to go into this Go Flex box. All right, you'll see why in a second, because it works really well. Look at that. Look at how perfect that is, the fit. And then the corresponding top of the egg carton to buffer it. And that glass object is real nice. And I have to tell you something. This GoFlex was on sale at Walmart. 2 terabytes USB 2.0 with the ability to upgrade the interface. It was on sale for like $79. What a, such a deal. And there is the final, of course, eco-friendly wrap. And this is To David from Alfred. And it's a Halloween Horror Seagate wrap. It's beautiful. And when you think of Halloween and horror, there's one particular song that comes to mind. Let's do a quick musical quaalude, interlude. Come on. I just scared the crap out of all my neighbors. Yeah, my friend David's a big fan of that Nightmare Before. I keep on wanting to say Nightmare Before Elm Street. I think I said that in the prior video. Nightmare Before Christmas paraphernalia. I like this stuff too. It's all pretty interesting, pretty funky. So here's a the Jack and Sally wall clock, and a What's This Jack head knocker. All right, but of course, you know, I always take advantage of word jokes. Let's do a little minor editing to both of these products. Notice I even matched the font. Let's not forget the glass toothpick holders. I got them at like, you know, 80% off because of how late this gift is. And there you have it. To David from Alfred, Nightmare Wrap, Part 1. Part 2. And Part 3. This was quite lovely. The toothpick holders fit very nicely in the Southern Supreme Nutty Fruitcake box. So I am recycling. I'll tell you, fruitcake has such a bad rap. I like it. I'm one of the few family members and friends that like that. If you listen, give it a try next holiday season. Just get a big glass of regular milk, slice it real thin, and just try it. I mean, the worst case, you can rewrap it and give it to someone that you don't like. But I like it. It's pretty good. Spiked up my triglycerides to like 500. Nice. I'm treating them with an Epicurean treat of Claxton fruitcake, and we are gonna record your reaction eating the fruitcake. So go ahead.
Okay.
Cut a piece.
I'm a little scared because there is no expiration date on this.
I'll knock it off. It's good stuff. Oh, knock it off, Bobby.
I can't get my knife through it. I gotta use it like a saw.
Yes.
I want to taste a little piece.
You're
of that.
Trying it.
I don't even want the whole damn thing. That's disgusting.
Barbara, you're gonna try it. You're a baker. You're gonna try it. Trust me, it's good.
I don't. Madeline said it doesn't have an expiration date.
Oh, you knock it off.
Yeah, Barb, you go first.
Gee, thanks.
You're older than me.
Do you have coffee? Do you have coffee, what? Barbara?
You need coffee. Excuse wash what? It down. It's
been no. You need a little coffee. Just don't snort it. Freaking eat it.
You're gonna wash
it's
it down
good.
You're gonna wash
it down. No, she has coffee.
It down with vodka.
It's good. It's a delicious fruitcake. It really is. What do you think?
It's tasteless.
Tasteless? What the hell happened to your taste buds? Too much freaking Nutri-freaking sweet?
I got a piece of raisins. Oh,
gross.
Get out of here.
It's a green piece of shit.
I got a red piece of shit in mine.
Please stop.
I'm picking it out.
Just try it.
Safe raisin to eat.
Try it.
That's not a raisin.
It's not very good.
Oh, wait. Oh, my God.
Johnny, listen. It may not be a raisin. Is it moving?
What the hell is it?
Just try it.
It's prunes.
It's not prunes.
Oh, it's gross. It's got candy shit in it.
Really? You don't like it?
The thing is, it's got candy crap in it.
No, I'm telling you. It's good. You said it's tasteless?
I'm not liking it.
I don't know. I eat two bricks of this
something's
shit.
Something's wrong with you.
Oh, yeah? A lot of people say that, Barb.
Al, you know what that
that's
means?
A given.
What?
You're going to be shitting bricks now.
Okay, here's a little aw moment. You ready? Because David collects this crap. Anything Nintendo, Mario. Aw, you ready? A little stocking stuffer, or you call it a birthday gift since his birthday was like a week prior, but that was like 2 months and a week prior. Whatever. Aw. It's a Mario doll. And how am I going to wrap this thing? It's going to fit real nice in this 100-calorie baked Cheetos Crunchy box.
Now, isn't this ironic? Isn't this great, us fat Americans? Now we pay more for less product so we can instill some type of self-control with restricted calories. I don't know. I just eat multiple packs.
Aw. Look at that. It looks like a little coffin. And what else can we add in there? Here's an actual candy cane that I actually fished out of the garbage pail because I had, like, I was in, like, toxic sucrose overload. But it's wrapped, so even though I fished it out of the garbage pail, whatever, it'll be fine. To David from Alfred, the Mario. Do you say Mario or Mario? I say Mario. Mario is dead wrap. And notice the care. The care and time and consideration of picking the Microsoft Comic Sans font. Dave being a graphic artist and an avid Mac user, I'm sure like it's like the most hated font on the planet. I don't know, I kind of like it.
You know, I really enjoy enhancing my friend Dave Sr.'s Blu-ray collection. That's Blu-ray, B-L-U, not B-L-E-W, Ray collection. He enjoys nice, wholesome, educational, quality movies for time with his family on a Sunday evening, and I do take the job of helping out. By the way, yes, white shirt. This can either be viewed as a continuity error or a standard clothing change. Opt for the clothing change. Anyway, moving right along, let's take a look at these wholesome family educational films that I got for him this, well, past Christmas season. Come on, take a look.
Now here's a fine educational film put on by Disney in association with PETA. The name of the movie is called Grindhouse, and this film really exposes the whole meat industry, and it focuses on how the animals are treated and whatnot for the processing of food. So yes, Grindhouse, a very good film by Disney in collaboration with PETA. This is another educational film also done by PETA, just for the animal rights activists. This is about a bunch of wackos that dress up in wacky costumes and they kick donkeys. They kick donkeys and they abuse these beautiful creatures. And yeah, the movie is called Kick Ass, and it really follows these individuals and how they were caught. A really fascinating movie. Here's another educational film called Scott Pilgrim, and it follows the life of a modern-day pilgrim and his interaction with Native Americans. Really quite educational and entertaining. Beautiful family movie. Really very nice. And this movie, Machete, put on by an environmental group, tells a tale of an individual going through the rainforest. Just the foliage and the animals, and it really is just a lovely family film, and it really teaches us to respect the rainforest and to preserve all the life there. So that's the lineup.
And those are indeed my picks for wholesome family entertainment. Alfred.tv at its finest, oh yes.
Especially driven by the two films, Grindhouse and Kick-Ass, which had a slant towards animal rights and PETA, I thought it would be appropriate to wrap actually all four movies in none other than an Omaha Steaks box. Let me show you how easy and efficient and eco-friendly this is. We just pop these in. So beautiful, nice, simple, and voila. Done. And the final wrap is quite lovely. And notice here we do keep the Omaha Steaks logo intact. Actually, with the bow covering it up, it's Aha Steaks. Aha! This steak is made out of meat, beef, cow. Two, Big Dave from Alfred. It's the PETA Educational Blue, BLEW Ray Collection. And there you have it. And for Debbie, she's getting the 2010... Gee, it's like a million years ago. The 2010... By the way, look at the cinematography here. Like I have the Christmas lights in the background to try to show you the ambient light reflecting through the crystal. Whoop-dee-doo. For Debbie, boy, for Debbie, the 2010, last year technically, the 2010 Traversery Savorsk, I can't effing say it, the 2010 Swarovski, fuck, the Swarovski fucking crystal. All right, there it is, and it's lovely. Look at this. It's a Christmas ornament that comes with, like, documentation. I don't know. What does it say inside? Step one, put up Christmas tree. Step two, hang ornament. Whatever.
Look, it was quite easy to wrap the Swarovski crystal. I just threw it in a small bag. Let me show you.
And there it is, a small bag. If I had the letter T in front of it, it would be a tea bag. And, yeah, it's in the bag from the BicoPacific.com jewelry company. This piece that you see me wearing here is from that company, BicoPacific. It's very cool stuff. So what is the wrap? How is it entitled? To Debbie from Alfred, it's not jewelry wrap. And what did I teach you over the years? What screams Christmas, holiday, love, and the birth of Christ? Nothing but industrial staples from an industrial stapler gun, said the way, spelled phonetically the way I say it, S-T-A-P-L-A. It's really quite nice. And for Kristen, what do we have? How about this? As I slowly move this into frame, a gift card for Victoria's Secret.
And what is Victoria's Secret? Let's go back from a retro clip with my niece and her friends from like years ago. Roll a clip.
My little angels wanted to go to the Boca Raton Mall, so I'm taking them. Now, let's find out what store did they want to go to.
Victoria's Secret.
And do you want to know what Victoria's Secret is? Or what is her secret? And her secret is that...
I heard she was a man.
I heard she's a crossdresser. I think she's a lesbian.
She's dead.
New for 2010, even though it's filmed sometime in February 2011. Look at this wrap job. Done. Yes, I wrapped the gift card in a Data Rescue 2 from ProSoft emergency hard drive and deleted file recovery box. It's gorgeous. This is like a freaking work of art. To Kristen from Alfred, it's not software wrap. And the fling. Blah. By the way, I do want to point out these very subtle embellishments for the ladies. The ho-ho-ho stickers. The ho-ho-ho stickers. Indeed, sometimes they do figure out and say, hey, Alfred calling us a bunch of hoes?
Is my name Ho Ho Ho?
Oh, you did notice.
Yeah.
You noticed?
Very nice.
You noticed
not
the ho
cool.
joke?
Not cool.
I did it to all the girls with that.
It's beautiful.
Did you notice the ho joke on there too?
Yeah.
I wasn't calling you a ho.
It was Mike trying to tell you, you guys have a little chat or something?
Yes.
I don't know about.
Here's a cool toy I got from my sister Deborah's fiance, Jim's grandson, Joey, for his birthday that just passed a few weeks ago. Oh, Joey, another little angel. Roll the clip.
Oh, Joey's gonna get on the act now too, huh? You little brat, knock it off. You know what, Joey? You're gonna get nothing for Christmas. Nothing for Christmas for you either. Nothing, zero, zilch, nothing, nada. Santa Claus doesn't exist. Santa Claus got run over by a truck. Santa Claus is dead. Get out of here, little brat. But look at this. It's the Star Wars, The Force Trainer, T-R-A-I-N-A-H. And it shows a kid that kind of looks like Justin Bieber reaching for a ball. Whatever. It's a headset, and it picks up brainwave activity. And as your brainwave activity goes up to the higher levels, like alpha, the ball, B-A-W-L, goes up. I was going to purchase this for myself, actually, to make a good, crappy, funny YouTube video, but I don't really need to show everyone when I have total brain death, so I think it'll make a lovely gift for the kid, and he's a quite bright child. He can use this to develop his, like, you know, mind meld techniques. Mind meld, that's Star Trek or whatever. Let's wrap this thing.
Holy cow! Holy cow! Holy cow! Holy cow!
Holy cow! Look at this. Look at this. This just might be the nicest gift I ever wrapped. Look at how beautiful this came out. But it's a deception. It's a deception. If we look at the undercarriage of this thing, I just ripped it. Eh. Delicate. I say nay, nay. We see. Yeah, I took the Christmas wrapping paper, turned it like the other way, and you get stars, but there's a little bit of leakage and a little bit of a hint of the gift underneath, but whatever. So it looks really good from the front, but from the back it looks like dog shit. But there you go. There you have it. It's a wrap. Boy, it looks really nice from this angle. Look at the cinematography here. Ooh, I'm going for like the videography award. Can you see how crappy this stuff is wrapped? Not really, but it does look so pretty. Nice. I think we got to shed a little light on the subject matter here so you can really see the full rectum spectrum of the wrap job. Yeah, so here it is. Wrap 2010, part 3, wrapped and filmed in 2011. A little bit of a Star Wars flyby. Wow, this stuff. Yeah, this stuff looks really horrible. And boy, are the kids going to be thrilled. I spoke to my cousin's husband, Todd, and I told him that gifts were on the way for his kids. He said, "Oh joy, Alfred, I can finally take down my Christmas tree." Let's go for the really good angle on this. Yeah, so away it goes via the UPS store tomorrow. Nice. Oh, yet there's one more bad joke. You see the stuff for my friend Dave and his family. Dave is such a Mac freak. Wait till you see the box it's going in. It's going in a Hewlett-Packard desktop PC box. Is that great or what? Is that like thoughtful? I think so. All right, time to ship all this crap at the UPS store.
Alfred, are you early for Christmas 2011 or late for 2010?
This is late for 2010, Diane, but just make sure you ship it slow boat, so because it's already late.
Not a problem.
Thank you.
You need a bigger fan. Your CPU is quite a hottie. Airflow is sloppy. Your motherboard runs hot, just like your girlfriend's tight and nicely. She's a tightly coated bot. Let's try it again.
And you may not. Let's do it again. Am I gonna edit it out? I don't know. Maybe not. Let's do it again. Ready?
Because the holidays, to me, are never over until I say it's over. You may think the holidays are over. I say nay, nay. They're not over. Why? Why? Let me give you a slow pan shot with the lights dimmed so you can see why.
And the holidays are not over because I have more gifts to wrap. And wow, this is a really shitty shot because you really can't see the gifts.
Aw. Welcome to Alfred.TV.